So you can head straight in.
Perfect. Well, hello, everyone. I hope everyone is staying safe and healthy. So first, just let me start by introducing Alvanon a bit. Alvanon is a body technology company for the apparel industry, and our focus is on the human body and its application to clothing. We help retailers and brands develop bodies, which we call fit standards, as well as help guide them through the process of implementing these standards throughout their supply chain. Over the course of the last 20 years, we have collected over 1.5 million body scans globally, which we use to analyze and develop statistically relevant body types for the different regions around the world. So to kick off today's presentation, I'd like to show you an image which some of you may be familiar with. As you can see, this is a striking image of a beautiful dress on a model. At first glance, a fairly straightforward advertisement that you might see in a magazine. The catch is, though, that this dress is not real. It's fully virtual. In fact, this dress was never produced, and I don't actually think it can technically be produced. It was sold only as a pure digital asset for a price of $9,500. Amazing, isn't it? In today's social media world, people can spend more money on a virtual dress than a real one. And I think this is wonderful if your company's business was centered around selling virtual clothing. But as far as I understand, most, if not all of you here today, work for companies that still sell real clothing. So when we showcase our products online to customers, we need to make sure that we are not just selling a pretty picture. Your customers want to trust that the products, when the products arrive in the mail, it looks and fits similar to the image that you sold them. And if that doesn't happen, you get a lot of complaints and returns. And it's clear that we as an industry have not done a very good job so far. Online apparel return rates still sit at around 30 to 40% today. Furthermore, the disconnect between what is promised and what is actually delivered actually erodes the trust between your brand and your customers. Authenticity matters because as a brand, trust is what creates loyalty with your customers. In 3D, you have a choice. You can build very pretty renderings that don't have anything to do with the actual product, like you saw just now, or you can build very pretty renderings that are identical to the real product. This is what we call authentic digital garments, whereby executing a proper digital workflow that is built on your brand's fit standards, you can achieve a final asset that marries the physical and the virtual world. An authentic digital garment should be production ready, validated in real life, fully graded, and contain all of the necessary components and technical specs. Most importantly, it is fully replicable. So how do you start building digital, authentic digital garments? Well, you start with the body. And if you want to do it right, you start with your company's fit standards. A fit standard is very different from any parametric digital body that you create within the 3D software. For starters, a fit standard exists as identical twins in both the digital and the real world. Another way of saying this is, your fit mannequin and your digital avatar need to be the same. This ensures that your digital garment and physical garment are fitted and assessed on exactly the same body. A fit standard is also a tool that can be distributed and used by your entire product development supply chain, which includes your vendors. Fit standards are developed based on body scans and data of your target market. They should address regional body shapes, age range, and other demographic criteria. More importantly, when developing a fit standard, shape and posture come before measurements. In the sportswear industry, you also have this to consider. Who is your target customer? The athlete or the fan? Here you see a CrossFit athlete has broad shoulders and a straight muscular torso. Next to it is a ballerina who has an hourglass-shaped body with longer legs but more muscular thighs. And then you have the rest of us who have aspirations but really just have a normal job. So which body are your garments built to fit on? Finally, a fit standard comes in more than just the core size. The size medium is a fraction of the entire solution. It's imperative that you develop your entire size range of bodies, so you are tackling and assessing the fit of every size in your assortment. In the past, developing a full size range of bodies was costly, but today with 3D, it's actually very, very feasible. With your fit standard in place, you can develop your core size garment in 3D and get a very good idea on the resulting fit of the garment. But while 3D is getting more and more accurate in terms of its true-to-life simulation, you'll still need to produce a physical sample. This physical sample needs to be dressed on the identical fit standard for validation and approval. Adjustments to the digital garment should be applied to the physical garment and vice versa. Then in 3D, you can grade the digital garment and simulate the fit on your entire size range of bodies. This will allow you to quickly validate your grade rules, but also let you visualize the fit of the garment in the largest and the smallest sizes. I think this is a game changer. But I think the real game changer is what we can now do with the digital fit standards. The biggest pushback from a lot of designers and brands in the past was that they didn't like working on fit mannequins because they didn't exhibit the look and feel of their models. So what a lot of brands elected to do is to use different digital avatars at different stages of the development cycle. And this is hugely problematic because you can't maintain the integrity of garment fit if you are fitting on different bodies. Thankfully, we can resolve this problem moving forward, and the entire product development chain can actually use the same fit standard. With new technology, we can add human-like features like muscle definition, realistic hands, feet, and head, while maintaining the body shape and measurements of the original fit standard. Furthermore, we can pose these human-like fit standards into various poses, while making sure muscle mass and body deformation are anatomically correct. So these here are some examples of some more common poses. Whereas in performance wear, you may be looking at developing very specialized poses, like yoga poses to test your garments on the extremities in movement. Or in other cases, even developing specialized performance wear for the Paralympics. This still, however, may not be enough to satisfy the demand of your designers. The avatar still does not look real enough. So moving a step forward, let's add human textures onto the fit standard, giving it hair, detailed facial features, skin, and maybe even a tattoo if you like. We can achieve a very good level of realism without compromising the body shape. Wouldn't it be interesting to have your digital garment simulated on a Caucasian woman for your Western market and an Asian female for the Asian market? There's a lot of intriguing possibilities. So let's combine all of these realistic elements together and take a look. Here's our original European men's fit standard, now posed with realistic textures wearing the same authentic digital garments. Tech designers could visualize and analyze the ease and fit of your digital garments so they can do so with the confidence that the underlying body is the same as the fit standard. Then, your designers could show their digital collections to the buyers. In the past, they might have just rendered the garment by itself. Now, they have the choice of rendering that garment with the realistic fit standard. Maybe even build a few poses that accentuate the look and feel of the collection. Then maybe the product team wanted to get some feedback on the design before they produced it. So post it on social media and count the likes, but I think you get the message. So again, use the digital and physical fit standard along the entire product development process and build authentic digital garments. There's a myriad of ways your company could leverage them in every aspect of your business, from strategic to product development to production. As an example, let's say that you wanted to offer your current collection in another region. As we know, there are major differences in the shapes and sizes of bodies in different parts of the world. Here we can see how the average body shape of the Chinese and the Japanese on the right differ from the average European and American body shape on the left. When a Western brand enters the Chinese market today, they might decide to stock more of the smaller sizes or even add an extra, extra small size to their current offering to try to cater to what they consider are smaller and thinner bodies. But we intrinsically know that it's not only that the Chinese body may be smaller, the proportions, the posture, and the shape of the bodies are also very different. With 3D, you can take your authentic digital garments and simulate them very quickly on the Chinese fit standards and objectively assess how well your current fit works. This will help you make better, more informed decisions about whether your current fit and grade works and whether you need to consider a separate regional fit. Finally, I'd like to present a simple idea about how we, as an industry, can tackle the billion-dollar question of creating a better online shopping experience for our customers and reducing returns. There are a lot of sizing and fit prediction apps out there today, and I'm sure that many of your companies are using them. How effective are they? Do your customers trust their results? Who knows? The truth is, though, we don't need to rely on predictive algorithms. There is a much more direct, accurate, and transparent method. In the near future, we will all have our own avatars. Scanning technology has come a long way, and phone scanning apps will, in the future, allow pretty much everyone to easily have a somewhat accurate avatar of their body. Your customers will be able to use the avatars within your virtual dressing room. And let's take these five customers with completely different body shapes and let's dress them. All of these individuals here are wearing the same digital garment in the same size. And you can see how their garments fit differently on each body. As long as you have your authentic digital garments built in all sizes, these individuals could select and visualize how a smaller or larger size would fit them and make an informed decision on which size to buy. With the advent of cloud processing and 5G, this can be simulated in real life. You could even let your customers see the tension maps to gauge how tight they want that fit to be. In any case, the result is authentic, transparent, and trustworthy. And it's certainly not a gimmick. But the best part about this is that you already did all the work. You are just leveraging the same digital assets that you created during the product development process. So to conclude, I think we have a unique opportunity today with the technologies and tools available to us to build a new future for the apparel industry, one where the digital and physical are closely connected and work together. Using the car analogy, we believe that you have to start your journey by building a good chassis. Begin laying the foundation by developing a library of authentic digital garments, which will become a core asset for your brand, allowing you to realize the many possibilities that digitization brings. I wish everyone a safe and healthy 2021. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Jason. That was really fantastic. A virtual dressing room, I'm sure that would avoid a lot of disappointment. I'm very much looking forward to it. I have a couple of questions from the audience. As a consumer, is it possible to carry your own individual 3D body and double check it with products at the POS so you can be sure it's fitting even though you haven't tried it?
That's the dream. That's exactly what this technology is about. The first step is to be able to have a library of these, actually these digital garments that mirror the actual product that is sold in the store. So the physical product mirrors the digital one. And the second step is, of course, to have a good enough technology to acquire an avatar of the individual customer so they could try it on. So I see in the next 2 to 3 years, we might start to actually see some of these technologies really start to become a little bit more mature.
Thank you very much. And the next question is, can I advertise with it if I'm embedding this in my production process?
I think absolutely. Absolutely, you can advertise with it. I think the whole thing about the whole digital creation chain is that you can take that digital product at any stage of the chain, take it out, and, you know, advertise with it, run it to your, you know, even out to with your marketing team, run it on your social media. And you can take it out at any point in time. You don't actually need to wait until the physical product is actually produced. So this is the advantage of actually digitization as well.
Thanks. Another question, the final question, how can you simulate the actual garment into the apps, like the armhole depth, etc.?
Well, that's a very technical question, and I think that is done actually in the 3D software itself. So each 3D software, you know, they cover all of these things where you can simulate the garment right onto the form, right onto the digital avatar itself. The accuracy may differ or may not be exactly perfect. However, you can get close enough. And once you get close enough, you have to make a physical garment to double check and validate it.
Well, thank you so much for giving us a look into the future. Thank you for your time. Take care. And for the people who can reach you in the chat for further questions, thank you very much, Jason.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.